While a firm can lose money in the short run, no firm can keep doing it forever. So what does the competitive equilibrium look like in the long run? Take a look at this figure. It illustrates that in the long run, a perfectly competitive industry will be in equilibrium where price equals average total cost. At this point, firms will earn what economists call alternatively either normal profits or zero economic profits. In order to understand this condition, let's first talk about what we mean when we say zero or normal economic profits. To do so, let's go back to our distinction in the last lecture between accounting profits and economic profits. Recall that accounting profits are calculated simply by subtracting total revenues and total costs. Recall further that what is left over after taxes is available to be distributed as dividends or kept by the firm as retained earnings. Now suppose you go into business for yourself, and in order to do so, you have to forego a $40,000 a year after-tax salary. That's the opportunity cost of your own resources of going into business. Now if you wind up at the end of the year with accounting profits of $40,000, you have earned zero economic profits because your accounting profits just cover your opportunity costs. It likewise follows that if you wind up with less than $40,000, your economic profits are negative, and more than $40,000, your economic profits are positive. Now let's generalize this zero economic profits concept to businesses and investors. Let's suppose that you have $100,000 that you just inherited from a rich aunt in Paducah who always thought you were a lovely child because you ate your broccoli. What do you do with the dough? Of course, you could blow it all on a Mercedes and a trip around the world, but suppose instead you decided to invest it. What kind of rate of return on your funds can you expect? Well, the conventional wisdom in economics is that if you invest your money in the stock market, over time, the inflation-adjusted real rate of return on your investment will be roughly 3 percentage points above the return you could have earned investing in risk-free government bonds. So, after adjusting for risk, any investment yielding you that return would be considered a normal profit or zero economic profits. And note here that your profit from an accounting standpoint isn't zero at all. You've simply been fairly compensated for your equity capital. No more and no less. By the way, we'll talk more about some of these investment considerations in our lecture on capital. With that said, let's go back to our long-run equilibrium condition to illustrate market performance under perfect competition. My claim is that, in the long run, a perfectly competitive industry will produce where price equals average total cost at its minimum and earn zero economic profits. The question, of course, is how does the industry remarkably wind up at this particular point? The answer lies in one of our original assumptions, free entry and exit into the market. Let's work this out together, and let's start with the total market for widgets and the individual firm in short-run equilibrium in this market. Note that the equilibrium market price is $50. Equilibrium quantity in the industry is 100,000 units, and economic profits are zero. Now, what do you think will happen to both of these figures after a report comes out in the American Medical Journal showing that widgets can reduce the incidence of Alzheimer's disease among senior citizens? Well, for starters, the demand curve will shift outward, reflecting an increase in demand. This will, in turn, increase the firm's price and marginal revenue and lead to an increase of profits above the zero level. But that's not all. What happens next? Because of the lure of high profits, additional firms will enter the industry. What will this do to the industry supply curve, price, and profits? The correct answer is B. Did you get it right? Entry by new firms shifts the supply curve out and returns the industry to long-run equilibrium. This drives the price back down to $50 and economic profits back to zero. So far, so good. But why does the process always stop at zero economic profits? Well, think of the process in reverse. Suppose that instead of extolling the virtues of widgets as a cure for Alzheimer's, the American Medical Journal had warned that widgets significantly increased the risk of breast cancer. What would have happened to demand and supply and price and profits? Take a minute to draw the adjustment process. Demand shifts in, price goes down, and so do profits. In the short run, firms can incur losses, but over the long run, they exit the industry. This shifts the supply curve in, driving up price, and driving economic profits back to zero. Thus, in the long run, perfectly competitive firms earn a normal profit, no more and no less. The importance of this conclusion about long-run equilibrium lies in its implications for the efficiency of the perfectly competitive market. We can think of efficiency in at least two dimensions of market performance: allocative efficiency and productive efficiency.